Well, if it ain't Charlie Moneybags, the big philanthropist. Howdy do.
What you talking about, Paul?
I'm talking about the underprivileged children's drive.
Oh, they collected for that at school, Paul.
Oh, I know they did. Oh, I know they did. And when they called your name, you gave the large, generous amount of 3 cents. My, that is big of you, Diamond Jim.
Did I give him too much, Paul?
Too much?
I could ask him to give back 2 cents.
Now, look at him. We better talk about this thing. Now, look here, Opie. You can't give a little bitty piddling amount like 3 cents to a worthy cause like the underprivileged children's drive. I was reading here just the other day where there's somewhere like 400 needy boys in this county alone, or 1.5 boys per square mile.
There is?
It sure is.
I never seen one, Paul.
Never seen one what?
A half a boy.
Well, it's not really a half a boy. It's a ratio.
Horatio who?
Not Horatio, a ratio. It's mathematics. Arithmetic. Look, now, Opie, just forget that part of it. Forget the part about the half a boy.
It's pretty hard to forget a thing like that, Paul.
Well, try.
Poor Horatio.
Now, look, Horatio is not the only needy boy. Son, didn't you ever give anybody anything just for the pleasure of it? Something you didn't want anything in return for?
Sure. Just yesterday, I gave my friend Jimmy something.
Now, that's fine. What'd you get him?
A sock in the head.
I meant charity.
I didn't charge him nothing.
I meant something for the joy of giving.
I enjoyed it. I don't like Jimmy no more. He makes fun of Charlotte.
Who's Charlotte?
My girlfriend.
Well, I just don't see how anybody who has got as much as you could care so little about others.
I care about others, honest.
Not when you give a little piddling amount like 3 cents. That's being selfish. You should have given at least a half a dollar or a dollar.
A dollar? Gosh, Paul, I only have $2.20 in my whole picky bank, and I'm saving it to buy Charlotte something.
Well, now, that's dandy. That is just dandy. Whole dollars you'll squander on your girlfriend, Charlotte, but when it comes to the underprivileged children's fund, you've got only 3 cents.
I wasn't gonna squander it, Paul. I wasn't gonna squander it.
Yeah.
What's squander?
That's throwing your money away foolishly.
Oh, but, Paul, I wouldn't be throwing it away.
All I can say is if your head can be turned by a pretty face at your age, heaven help you when you're grown up. You see that apple right there?
Yes, Paul.
Now, that's the only one in the bowl, ain't that right? Now, suppose me and you both wanted that apple, and I grabbed it and wouldn't give you half of it. Now, how would you feel?
I wouldn't mind.
You wouldn't?
There's a worm in it.
Opie, that's beside the point. I'm trying to give you an example of sharing. Now, I'd take half, and I'd give you half. Now, that's sharing, and it's fair to everybody concerned.
No, it ain't, Paul.
It ain't.
No, you didn't leave nothing for the worm.
You don't have to carry the thing that far. You don't share things with worms.
Why not?
Well, because they ain't like people. They don't work or wear clothes or go to school or anything. All they do is lay around all day inside of apples and eat.
That's all they do?
That's all.
Boy, and I was feeling sorry for them.
I got a feeling we're kind of drifting here. It's all right. You're saving to buy your little girlfriend Charlotte a toy. That's all right this time, I expect.
No, Paul.
Or if you want to take her to the movies and buy her $2 worth of popcorn, that's all right.
I'm gonna buy her a coat.
After all, it's your savings and whatever you... Well, Opie, you never told me that's what the money was for.
You never asked me.
Yes, I didn't, did I?
What are we having for supper?
Well, you and Aunt B's having fried chicken, and I'm having crow.